Long overdue vlogs. Footage I shot quite some time ago, but didn't get around to finally editing till much later. It's long overdue vlogs.
Hey everyone, Dave here, and it's a very emotional day for me. This is the last day I will likely ever set foot in this house. The house that I grew up in for most of my childhood and teenage years, and even spent quite a bit of my adulthood. Tonight I'm staying with friends, and then tomorrow I'm beginning my road trip to California, where I will be living for the foreseeable future. It's very rough to say goodbye to what has really been my home for basically the past 20 years. We moved to this house in 1995, and then even when I lived other places, this was still what I considered home. I can't even put into words what it feels like to be saying goodbye to this place for the last time. Anyway, tomorrow begins my road trip to California. This is me rambling into my camera that is currently resting on the shelf in the closet of the house that I will very soon no longer live in and will never come to again. This is very sad. Let me give you a tour of the house.
Okay, first off, there's the backyard. It's covered in snow. Because of the snow, you can't see that it's usually just dirt. Patches of grass, but it's not a very green yard. This was my closet. This is where my bed was for a lot of time. This corner, this used to be blue, but you've seen this corner in my cameo clapping along to Tramtastic in Charlie's first Universal video. Over here is where Nick's bed was for a lot of our life. I often dangled a green screen from here, just hung it up and set up the lights, and that's how that went down. This is a bathroom, you know what those are. This room has been used by basically every member of the family except Nick. When we first moved here, this was Mom and Dad's room. Then as we kids got a little older, it became my sister Lizzie's room. And then when Lizzie was off at college, but I moved back from Florida and had nowhere else to go, this became my room. So Nick and I could have separate rooms. It's got this neat attic space here. This is our attic. This used to be filled with boxes and bins, and now it's just filled with dust. So we moved here in 1995. Until 2002, these upstairs rooms were a lot smaller. You can sort of see marks. Then we had the upstairs renovated and had them expanded out. That's interesting, right? Coming down to the first floor, this was the living room. There was usually some form of couch either here or here. I don't know how many of you have seen my the old short we did when I was in 10th grade, Road to Success, the Jesse Thomas story. We used this living room for most of that short film. This was the dining room. And this was the kitchen. This is our back porch. Used to sort of double as our pantry. We just had shelves full of food and really just grocery bags full of groceries just piled up everywhere. This room, when we first moved to the house, was the guest room slash office. Then when Lizzie moved into the other room upstairs, this became Mom and Dad's room. And it actually looks a lot smaller without the bed in it. I'm amazed that humans were actually able to live in this room. When we were redoing the house to sell it, Mom and Dad moved back up to that upstairs room because that had to be the master bedroom when we were showing the house. So, I moved down here, and that's how that goes. This is, the other bathroom. Look at it as a bathroom. And then the basement is where, most of the action happened. Basement, most of our life was basically our house's entertainment center. We had the TV over there, couch right here. Autofocus is not really autofocusing. Whatever. It's a blurry basement that no longer has the furniture anyway. Back when we had a desktop computer, it usually lived in this corner. When was the last time we had a desktop computer, I ask you? You wouldn't know, you weren't there. When was the last time you had a desktop computer? And, laundry room, extra freezer for the long-term frozen foods. It's basically a house. There's the wireless router that I really need to pack up. I realize none of this means anything to you, but every single room I'm showing you is loaded with just so many memories and emotions for me, and even though the furniture's all gone, I already went through this sort of grieving process when the furniture left, and now I'm going through this grieving process again, just realizing I'll never set foot in these rooms again. These rooms that I spent more time in than anywhere else on the planet, most likely. Just, yeah, it's a sad day, but also an exciting day. You know, we travel to California a lot, and I've always loved visiting California. I'm excited to live there. I feel like California will agree with me. I have friends out there, and of course, there's none of this stuff. You see this stuff? This stuff is not there. There's no piles upon piles. Sad to say goodbye to this house. Not so much sad to say goodbye to the snow. Yeah, I got my good last winter in there. Tuesday afternoon, and I am here at the Pennsylvania Welcome Center just off of I-78. Made it through Connecticut and New York and New Jersey with no traffic to speak of, so today is officially my shortest driving day since I'm spending tonight here in Pennsylvania. I went to college in this state. Many of my dearest friends from college still live here. I'm excited to see several of them, but I've never really gotten the tourist experience of Pennsylvania, which apparently exists, so I thought I'd check out this welcome center and see what's here to welcome me.
Smile, dammit, smile!
Here, kids, come play with brochures! Grove City Premium Outlets, the only outlet endorsed by the love child of Heather Graham and Gillian Jacobs. Tanger Outlets, the only outlets endorsed by the love child of Megan Fox and Kat Dennings. Historic Baker Mansion, we're pretty sure it's not haunted.
Pottersville. You mean Bedford County?
St. Mary's, Pennsylvania. Come stay with us and witness our world-famous intersections. Check out a heritage sampler and let us stare into your soul. Still a more faithful adaptation than Man of Steel. The Chocolate Kingdom has been planning their siege on Hershey Park for years. Indiana County, Pennsylvania. Because Kansas City, Missouri wasn't quite confusing enough.
You must choose, but choose wisely. For while the true comfort inn will give you life, the false comfort inn will probably just be out of the way of your desired route.
Ride old-time trolleys, dammit.
Come on, George R.R. Martin, stop wasting time on your furniture hobby and write some books. Harrisburg Mall, the only mall endorsed by the love child of Emma Stone and Emma Stone.
Opportunity knocks once, let's reach out and grab it.
Yeah!
Together we'll nab it.
We'll hitchhike bus or yellow cabin.
Cabin?
So this is one of those things that we'd always pass when I was heading to and from college and never bothered to check it out, but seeing as I'm making really good time and
I'm also something of a reviewer of tourist attractions. I might as well check it out.
Thank God for model trains.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, if they didn't have the model train, they wouldn't have gotten the idea for the big trains.
Whenever I'm out wandering, chasing a rainbow dream, I often stop and think about a place I've never seen.
Where friendly folks can gather and raise the rafters high
with songs and tales of yesteryear until they say goodbye.
Well, there's a
puppy in the fodder and a skillet on the stove and a smelly old blanket that a Navajo wove. There's popcorn in the popper and a porker in the pot. There's a pie in the pantry and the coffee's always hot. There's sausage in the morning and a party every night. There's a nurse on duty if you don't feel right. There's chicken on the table, but you gotta say grace.
There's
always something cooking at Old Joe's place.
Please warn your children about the danger of playing in fire. And then check out our outhouse.
Outhouse.
Here's where the tourist trap advertises other tourist traps.
Hey, look, dinosaurs. It's a diorama of the diorama in the Disneyland train.
And here we have the town from Big Thunder Mountain Railroad. All right, well noted. Do you remember these days where the cub bear watched the dogs? Pepperidge Farm doesn't either.
Press and hold the button to play the hurdy-gurdy.
Tell your children how Henry Ford was a hobbyist. Encourage them to waste time on their hobbies, like YouTubing. Yeah, anyone could climb the Appalachians if they actually had staircases. And now, a panoramic view of America. And all of its white people.
From Ural to Shining Mirror.
Hey, I can see my house from here. But before the model settlers moved in, the cardboard natives lived here. What are you talking about? The end's right there. It's a wall. All right, now I'm just reenacting scenes from Werewolf.
Hey, did I have too much mezcal, or does anyone else see those Indians in the sky over there?
Boy, electric trains are loud. Finally, America's greatest work of literature. So, final verdict. If you're a fan of model trains and miniatures and Americana, and you're in the area, it might be worth checking this out. It's, it's as much fun as miniatures and model trains are to you, but it is an impressive amount of detail that has been here for quite a long time and was reportedly put together basically by just one man. So that man was very passionate and very patient. And this is coming from a guy who edits videos. I'm pretty sure that's just another misspelling of Gary Gergich.
R.I.P.
Oh, the guy at the Black Store thought you had died. It was a rush job, so we didn't have time to change it.
Shardlesville.
We're having fun in Balloon Land.
Moving right along, footloose and fancy free.
Getting there is half the fun, come share it with me.
Greetings from a Travelodge in Carlisle, Pennsylvania. As far as Travelodges go, this is not the sketchiest one I've stayed in, but it has a couple of sketchy things. When I first got here, this faucet was just dripping, was just on, and it's actually fine now, but when I got here, it was not only dripping, it was dripping a lovely shade of just slightly yellow water. Fortunately, that seems to have cleared up, but evidently something was going on there. There are a couple minor stains, but you know, nothing like that motel we stayed at before MAGFest this year. Really, the biggest thing is, I don't know how well you can hear it, but there's a rattling sound coming from here that I think is just the sound of the door being locked. Because when I open it, rattling sound goes away. When I close it, there it is again. Other than that, this is an acceptable travel lodge, so I'm going to hang out with friends in Pennsylvania. Because I have those. Just like the license plate says, you have a friend in Pennsylvania. It's true, I do. I have multiple. What are even the odds? You don't have to calculate them. I won't hold you to that question. All right, I'll check in with you later. I'll get video proof that I actually saw you guys. Yeah, I'm in Harrisburg seeing friends. Do you have any words for the camera that it probably won't be able to hear?
Thanks for coming to Harrisburg.
Good luck out there.
Hey, thank you. That works. Well, I'm glad they told us each of those different rates. So as you can see, the room is pretty spacious. It's got a lot of room. Has a fridge there. It does not have a microwave in the room. Fortunately, that's why there's this communal microwave in the hallway for all to enjoy. Just here in the hallway by the exit. I'm sold. I enjoy this little dip in the road you have to drive through to get up here to the motel. The motel behind the other motel. And here I am on my old college campus. Ah, the memories. They certainly were a time. You might recognize this counter from the Mario and Luigi video. Looks like it's actually in more active use now than it was back then. Be harder to poorly make look like a bar nowadays. There's the sound of one of the trains that would often go by in the middle of the night, or middle of the day in this case. Here's a piece of art that was, it was here when I was in college, but I somehow never worked it into a film or video, so I'm working it into a video now. Look at this tree teepee or whatever this thing is. Soak it in. Campus theater where many of my classes were, but I won't enter it right now because there's a class in there as we speak. And down there you can sort of make out the creek known as the Yellow Breeches. The trail along that creek was probably my favorite spot on campus. And when I say spot, I mean long, long trail to walk along. I spent many's a time walking along that trail, which it was an exercise trail. It had exercise spots that I completely ignored because I was just walking and listening to my Walkman because I didn't have an iPod yet. I was one of those kids. And we also filmed movies in the woods along the trail. Good times. Ah, the very, very, very expensive memories.
Moving right along, we'll learn to share the load. We don't need a map to keep this show on the road.
And now I'm in Maryland, the state built on the remains of Queen Mary's abandoned theme park. Maryland, the merriest place on earth. Why are you pestering us? Go explore your own damn Chesapeake. Yes, after Emmett saved Bricksburg, they renamed themselves after him. And everything was indeed awesome.
Moving right along, we found a life on the highway.
And your way is my way.
So trust my navigation.
Here are my grandparents. So I have to see them along the way.
Do you get sound too, right?
There is sound, yes.
Oh, my word.
Yes. Oh, we're so delighted that you came to see us, David.
We sure are.
And it is wonderful. You don't get a chance to spend some quiet time with one grandchild that often. As you know, we usually have lots,
crowds.
Which we love, but this is special. It's wonderful.
A great pleasure to us that you've been here, David.
It's been wonderful.
Especially if you don't get lost on your way to D.C.
Yes.
Well, we have to have confidence.
California, here we come high in the skyland.
Palm trees and warm sand.
Though sadly we just left Rhode Island.
We did what?
Just forget it.
Well, I thought I had made it to Virginia, but judging from the giant word love in the middle of the field, apparently I'm back in Philadelphia. I knew I shouldn't have trusted my GPS. And now I'm in a Motel 6 in Virginia. So you can see it's a smaller room than the Pennsylvania Travelodge, but at least this room has its own microwave. And after all, isn't that the deciding factor of any lodging, is microwavability? America, home of food.
I'm moving right along.
Hey, LA, where have you gone?
Send someone to fetch us, we're in Saskatchewan.
I'm here with my dear friend Liz. We are here on the shuttle going around Colonial Williamsburg, finding stuff.
Random things.
Getting lost, mostly.
Yeah, this is my first time vlogging. I've never done this before.
I'm sorry, your first time is on such a disappointing vlog.
No, you're my cool internet friend. It's totally fine.
Yes, I'm somebody's cool internet friend.
Yeah, so we're just trying to use this useless map that's way too big. And the part that we really want is just this. But instead, it's telling us all the info about, you know, the interstate.
We do a lot of interstate walking while we're looking at the old buildings.
Yeah, especially in the winter, like the roads are so good in the winter. You have to walk them all.
Gotta walk them all. It's the Pokemon of roads. The historic Williamsburg sheep. Way overexposed on my camera.
They're saying Dave.
Yeah, that's it.
How do we get across this white stuff?
They're all trapped in their own little... Oh, that one's making a run for it. And he stopped.
The one is in the way. He's gonna jump over it.
There's no way to get around this.
These are people who worshipped in the church.
Mm-hmm.
They did not necessarily sit in this pew.
Okay.
And here we have the great historical colonial Barnes & Noble. Just as it stood 200 years ago.
Moving right along, doggy-dong, you take it, you know best.
Hey, I've never seen the sun come up in the west.
And now I'm officially in the south, now that I've reached a state with north in the name. This is the first motel of my entire trip that has actually provided shampoo. Finally, I can take a break from my own diminishing supply. Ha ha ha! First world budgeting problems. Guys, I think I've been kidnapped by someone.
What the fuck are you doing in my car?
I don't know how I got here or who this man is, but I'm very alarmed.
Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out. Shut that thing off.
Oh man, I just drove through a Carolina. Now I have to drive through another one? All right, I made it through South Carolina, and I am now in a Super 8 in Commerce, Georgia. That is the name of a town, apparently. Now, this motel has nothing in the way of a fridge or a microwave. But yeah, no fridge, so I'm hoping it was cold enough outside last night that my food in my cooler doesn't go bad. But they make up for the lack of food supplies with plenty of toilet paper. Finally, you can dual-wield toilet paper at the same time. Isn't that what America is all about when it's not about food? I ask you. Anyway, today is the first day that I don't have plans to see anybody on the road, so I'm just gonna drive until I pull over and look at something interesting. See you then.
Moving right along, we're truly birds of a feather. We're in this together, and we know where we're going.
So growing up, my family would travel a lot, so I've been to a lot of states, 46 in fact. The only United States that I have not been to are Alaska, Hawaii, Louisiana, and Alabama. There's only four states I haven't been to. And now there's only three states I haven't been to. Did I mention I'm in the South? All pets must be on a leash, and must walk in the designated areas only, and must just straight up not exist.
Movie stars with flashy cars and life with the top down.
We're storming the big town.
Yeah, storm is right. Should it be snowing?
No, I don't think so.
And I'm not in Alabama anymore. But I am in the rain, so let's go into this welcome center and rectify that scenario.
Only one thing I did wrong. Stayed in Mississippi way too long.
So I've been on the road a couple days now, seeing a lot of state visitor centers. This is far and away the fanciest one I've seen. It's very welcoming and very nicely decorated.
Moving right along. Do I see signs of men?
Yeah, welcome on the same post that says come back again.
And now there's only two states I haven't been in. And they're the non-contiguous ones, so who even really cares? They barely even count as states. Yeah, I'm in Louisiana now, and I can say Louisiana too. I am capable of pronouncing Louisiana. It's raining again, so I'm getting back in the car.
Moving right along, nice town.
Footloose and fancy free.
You're ready for that big time.
Is it ready for me?
And now I've arrived at my Motel 6 in Shreveport, Louisiana. You know, the LA that's not my final LA destination, but apparently they gave me a handicapped room tonight, which means I get to shower sitting down. I can truly be lazy and clean at the same time. I'm not sure if that's why the whole room kind of looks like a hospital room or if that's just the motif here at this particular Motel 6, but whatever the case, I am really tired and the camera's out of focus anyway because the camera is, well, actually, yeah, that gives you a pretty good idea of what everything looks like through my eyes right now. So, good night, everyone. And now I'm in Texas. And I will be for the next 12 plus hours. This'll be a fun drive of longness. Damn it, now where are my cattle supposed to graze? So I basically spent all day yesterday driving through Texas. Driving. It's a big state. It's also a repetitive state. Basically, every half hour to 45 minutes, you'd pass an exit that seemed to have the exact same TA or Love's Travel Stop. And then there'd be a bunch of exits in between that didn't seem to have anything. And then about every 100 miles there'd be the same exact rest area with just vending machines and a restroom. And between those there'd be the picnic areas with just picnic tables and that's it. It basically, the state basically feels like you're driving in circles forever. But after driving for, you know, 7,000 hours yesterday, I made it here to Van Horn, Texas, where I only have 1,000 hours left of Texas to go. Basically, I've been booking all my motels online through, through a discount website that I have access to because I am a service industry employee of a company that really, really likes people. Really likes the people at work who work for it, or at least they throw money at the people who work for it. I'm not going to tell you the name of the company, but they serve coffee and they're everywhere, except, oddly enough, exits off of Route 20 in Texas. I have seen very few of them. Point is, they have this discount service for all sorts of products for its employees, including motels, and I've been booking through their website, but since I am one of those old fogies who does not have a smartphone, I basically have to pull over somewhere with Wi-Fi and use my laptop to book motels each night, and it took a long time to find an exit that had a place with free Wi-Fi anyway. Eventually I saw McDonald's off one exit, you know, after hours of searching. I was like, okay, good, they'll have Wi-Fi. They had Wi-Fi, they didn't have outlet, so my laptop battery died faster. Well, their Wi-Fi was really slow, so my Wi-Fi battery died before I could book the motel, so I had to keep going and find a McDonald's with an outlet. Eventually I found one, booked my motel here in, again, in Van Horn, Texas, where my room was right next to some loud drunk frat guys. The walls were paper thin, so if anyone's in the rooms next to me, they hear me ranting right now. The toilet would, you know, run for a long time after flushing, so you'd just hear water running. And of course you'd hear water running from the other adjoining rooms. And at one point in the night, when my door was closed, somebody else using their key accidentally started to come into my room before realizing they had the wrong room, but they managed to open the door. So I hope they were an employee. Otherwise, it is just really, really, really easy to enter any room once you have a key here. So yeah, deadbolt went up after that, but today I will eventually make it out of Texas, and we'll see how far I get from there. Let's wrap up this adventure. As you can see, I am very, very tired. I have been on the road a long time, and I don't remember what things are anymore. Well, most of Texas may be empty, but there sure are some pretty things. Off in the distance under the really, really, really gray sky. Also, there are trucks. Trucks that appear to be making off with part of the highway. I'm probably gonna be behind that guy. That'll be fun. Maybe I'm already in Cars Land. And I am finally out of Texas. At long last. Don't know if that did anything. Yes, folks, be sure to try out our new InvisiVend for all your invisible vending needs. See that? That's Texas back there. For the past 24 hours, most of the exits I've seen have looked exactly like that, except even less populated.
even fewer stops. A couple times I passed through a city that had like an actual outlet mall, and I've never been so happy to see plenty of chain shops and chain restaurants that I didn't actually care about, just because it showed that there were people nearby. But for the most part, it's just been a bunch of that. I'm sure Texas is a lovely state to live in when you actually get to the habitated parts, the parts people are actually living in. But Texas along I-20 and I-10, some nice scenery, but mostly a whole lot of nothing. Let's see if New Mexico fares any better. Well, I'm here at the Continental Divide, which to me is just sad because I think we should be trying to unite the continent, not drive it apart. As you can see, this building has evolved to make itself look like a gas station to lure in unsuspecting tourists. And there's New Mexico. It's similarly empty to Texas, but not nearly as large as Texas, and not hitting your head with the repetition of the exits. So that's nice.
Moving right along.
And now I have arrived in Arizona. A state very proud of its signs. Yes, San Simon. Right past At Gene and Malgraining.
Watch out for snakes.
Moving right along.
Alright, I stopped off here for gas, but before I get back on the highway, I have to talk about this. Basically, as soon as I got into New Mexico, I started seeing billboards for The Thing in Arizona. Just constantly, you know, 300 miles ahead, Dairy Queen, gas, and The Thing? Question mark. Talk about a vague tourist trap. I mean, at least Roadside America told me what it was, but this is basically just saying, come off here and see some sort of object? Maybe? The Thing? Even Grunkle Stan thinks we're not trying.
Moving right along.
Well, folks, we did it. I have arrived in California. This rest stop doesn't really have a welcome center or even a welcome to California sign, but it is located off the exact same exit as a state prison, so it's got some nice don't pick up hitchhiker signs, which is very reassuring for a rest area. But yes, I am very happy to say that I have finally made it to California here at this late nighttime. I'm not even sure what time it is because every clock in my car is set on a different time zone and I sort of lost track of which one is set on which. And my phone has not caught up to the current time zone. So I could drive to my new home now, but I'm not leaving until I get my full 8 hours worth of parking, damn it. See you tomorrow.
Moving right.